Arduino filled a huge gap between, you know, the world, the elite hardware engineers and firmware engineers and common people. We can take complexity and scramble it in a way that we can make it simple and accessible. So I think Arduino gave a chance to a huge amount of people to be creators and enablers of technology.
Arduino started as a hacker group within an interaction design institution in Ivrea.
And they used to meet in a bar. They spotted this name of the bar that was Arduino and was named after an Italian king. So basically the bar was named after the king and Arduino was named after the bar. So
it quickly evolved into something much, much bigger because this became a very easy to use tool for everyone.
You make it accessible to very young people and you make it amusing for them. And that is very, very, very beautiful, beautiful thing.
I mean, what really started as a way for artists and creative people to express themselves became a tool that is so easy to use that is used everywhere to prototype quickly, even very complex applications.
When I was a kid, I took apart our VCR, and you could look at that and understand at a basic level what's happening. Now you look at new products and you have no idea what you're looking at. And if we're gonna continue to churn out new engineers and scientists and people who want to build these sorts of things, these people need access to things that they can dissect. So the latest project in my book for using a stepper motor is a simple chronograph. But one of the nice things about Arduino is it's an excellent platform for not just doing things in a recipe book, duplicating things that someone else has done, but understanding why they work. And you can operate at this higher level while using the platform, which is nice, but you can also quite easily get into learning at the more physics level why electronics are working the way that they're working.
You can enjoy the fact that you're not just a consumer of electronics, but you can become someone who understands what's behind.
You can do basically anything with an Arduino, a hot glue gun, and popsicle sticks.
The design process in Arduino is very different from a pure engineering work. In Arduino, the focus is really the user. Is the user really needing this, and how will he use it? If you start asking these questions first, then you start to migrate from the engineering point of view, which is, I want to squeeze as many features as possible, it must be technically challenging, and so on, to something meant for users of any kind.
Programming a microcontroller can be really complicated, and Arduino really democratized this process by saying, you have a USB cable, you can program a microcontroller. And that's huge. And it's why I still come back to using the Arduino as a prototyping platform all the time. One of the great things for me about using the Arduino as a prototyping platform is I feel like I can kind of experiment as I go, and I don't necessarily have to have the entire project in mind when I start working on it. And sometimes that's the most fun way to learn about things.
A great engineer should be very open-minded. I didn't know if I wanted to become an artist or a physicist. Then I ended up with a PhD in physics, but in this reality, you can be both creative and methodic.
Our product families are now made of much more complex hardware design. We wanted to support also a different way of manufacturing products, looking after the entire lifecycle management.
As a professional electrical engineer working at Shaper, where we make handheld robotic power tools, for much of our factory test fixtures, we use Arduino-based electronics. I can make something that's custom suited to do exactly what we want, exactly the way we want to do it. For the key parts of the schematic that I want to duplicate, I'll just recreate the schematic in Altium Designer, and then I just go to town on whatever other features I need to do. These power various calibration routines. It's so ideal for this sort of stuff.
it's really very important to have hardware design seen as close as possible to software design. So iterations must become much faster and collaboration must use modern tools.
The potential that you can exploit by combining the hardware and the cloud is really immense. So we are investing heavily in research and development because I think we haven't scratched, there is no limit to what can be done with this technology.
A good Arduino user should be creative, yeah. Someone is going to put a board on the moon. It is very impressive.
There is a company who's launched our boards in space, and they are doing experiments in the International Space Station. So actually you can purchase a kit which allows you to do physics experiments at home to simulate exactly the same experiment and see what's different. So you can really find Arduino stuff everywhere. It's just impressive.
So when you have millions of people that work on projects, the power, the collective power of the community, I think, is a very strong thing, and it's important that we keep not only taking from the community, but also giving back to the community.
What I learned from life is that it is good to share.
Whenever you listen to a pitch of a startup, they claim at the end of the pitch, and we are going to change the world with this technology. I think among all the startups that claim to change the world, Arduino changed the world already by providing this democratization of technology that made the difference.
Thank you for watching Altium Stories. If you enjoyed what you've seen, please give us a like and share the video, and don't forget to subscribe. We'd love to hear what you think, so please leave a comment in the section below.